Delaney had a donkey that everyone admired. Temporarily lazy and permanently tired. A leg at every corner, balancing his head, and a tail to let you know which end he wanted to be fed. Riley slyly said, "We've underrated it. Why not train it?" Then they took a rag, they rubbed it, scrubbed it, they oiled and embrocated it. Got it to the post, and when the starter dropped the flag, there was Riley pushing it, shoving it and shushing it. Hogan, Logan and everyone in town lined up attacking it, shoving it and smacking it. They might as well have tried to push the town hall down. The donkey was eyeing them, openly defying them, winking, blinking and twisting out of place. Riley reversing it and everybody cursing it. The day the lady's donkey ran the half mile race. Muscles of the mighty, never known to flinch, they couldn't move the donkey a quarter of an inch. Delaney lay exhausted, hanging round his throat, with a grip just like a Scotsman on a 5-pound note. Starter Carter lined it with the rest of them. When it saw them, it was willing then. It raced up, braced up, ready for the best of them. They started off to cheer it, but it changed its mind again. There was Riley pushing it, shoving it, shushing it. Hogan, Logan, Mary Ann McGrath, she started poking it and grabbing it and choking it. It kicked her in the bustle and it laughed, hee-haw! Whigs and conservatives, the radicals superlative, liberals and Tories, they hurried to the place, stood there in unity, helping the community. The day Delaney's donkey ran the half-mile race. Began to cheer it, and Rafferty the judge, he came up to assist them, but still it wouldn't budge. And the jockey who was riding it, little John McGee, was so thoroughly disgusted that he went and had his tea. Egg and Fagin were students of psychology, swore they'd shift it with some dynamite. They bought it, brought it, and without apology, the donkey gave a sneeze and blew the whole thing out of sight. There was Riley pushing it, shoving it and shushing it. Hogan, Logan and all the bally crew. Police and auxiliary, the garrison artillery, the second in the skillings and the lifeguards too. They seized it and harried it, they picked it up and carried it, cheered it, steered it to the winning place. Then the bookmakers, they drew aside, and they all committed suicide. The day Delaney's donkey won the half-mile race.